Hello, I am Gaston Lansner, and I am happy to present you today our paper, DZIR, Deep Image Segmentation with Interactive Refinement. I will begin this presentation with a short demo of the tool that we developed for this work. So here is an image from the dataset ISPRS Potsdam, and the goal is to do a semantic segmentation of the scene, or in other words, a pixel-wise classification of this image. So to do so, we do an initial prediction with a neural network trained on this dataset, and this image has not been seen during training. So here the colors are in transparent the roads, in blue the cars, in green the vegetation, in cyan the trees, in yellow the building, and in magenta the clutter. So as we can see, the initial segmentation is already pretty accurate. However, this building has not been fully captured by the neural network. And in our work, we refine the segmentation initially proposed by the neural network to enhance its initial prediction with user annotations. So here I put two building annotations, and the neural network refine the segmentation. And here is a corrected segmentation of this image. As we can see, it's very fast because there is no retraining. I will now present more in depth how this framework works. As shown in the demo, the core idea of our framework is to add a human in the loop in order to interactively improve the segmentation maps output by a neural network. So there is an initialization phase where the neural network proposes an initial segmentation of the scene, and then it iteratively uses user annotations as guidance to enhance its initial prediction. So this is the interactive loop. These annotations represent the labels of the clicked pixels, and they are concatenated at the input of the network with the RGB image. So there is no retraining. Indeed, it is only the inputs of the networks which are modified and not its weight, and this guarantees the swiftness and the smoothness of the approach. I now delve in the details of the annotations, which really are at the core of our framework. They are simulated from the ground truth during training and to automatically evaluate it. So on one hand, during training, to let the neural network learn how to be guided by these annotations, and on the other hand, for automatic evaluation, to automatically test if our framework works. We also studied two aspects of these annotations. So first, the positioning, the inside clicks or border clicks. So inside clicks means that the clicks are located in the middle of the instances, so for example, in the middle of a car, while the border clicks means that they are located between two instances, so for example, to delimitate a car from the road. And we also studied the encoding of the annotations, so binary clicks or Euclidean distance transforms, as shown in this image. And we found out, as reported in the paper, that inside clicks with Euclidean distance transforms seems to be the most efficient combination to make the most of the annotations. We also analyzed the distribution of the annotations. So as I said, we automatically evaluated our framework, but we also evaluated it with a real user in the loop. And as we found out, a real user tends to focus its clicks on specific areas, so as it can be shown in the right image, while synthesized clicks mostly tend to be spread all across the image, as it can be shown on the left image of the figure. But as we reported in the paper, we observed noticeable improvement of the metrics in both cases. So this shows that the two evaluation processes showed that our framework is efficient. Now I present some results of our approach. So we evaluated our framework on the two datasets, the INRIA dataset and the ISPRS dataset. The INRIA dataset is composed of two classes, buildings and not buildings, and I presented the ISPRS dataset in the demo. We sampled 120 clicks per image to evaluate our framework. And as shown here, we observed an improvement of the IOU of around 5% for both datasets. So this shows that our approach is effective. And we also observed an average number of 5,000 corrected pixels per click. And here is also an example of our framework in a building segmentation case. So in the initial segmentation, the neural network efficiently captures the buildings, but it also predicts wrongly predicts two sports fields as buildings. And these annotations, the three annotations, efficiently correct and refine the initial segmentation proposal. I now present two aspects of our work that we investigated. First, here on the left, the architecture choice. In our work, we mostly used a link net, which is similar to a U-net with a ResNet encoder and a lot of skip connections. However, as shown by this graphic, applying our method to various neural network architectures with different initial performances lead to similar marginal gains. So, it essentially appears that our method is independent from the neural network architectures. We also studied the influence of the training set size on the performances of our framework, here shown on this figure on the right. And at the top, there is the initial IOU performance, and at the bottom, the IOU gain, both for neural networks trained on increasing fractions of the training image database. On the right here, there is the best performance we can obtain, because this is the performance we obtain trained on the entire dataset. We can also observe that there is a plateau reached once there is enough training data. However, this plateau is different for the two datasets. Indeed, for the Inria dataset, it is already stabilized with only 10% of the annotations, while the plateau is reached for more than 50% of the initial training database for the ISPOS dataset. This stems from the fact that the two datasets have an initial size really different. Indeed, the Inria dataset is much bigger than the ISPRS dataset. And finally, what we learn here is that for two small datasets, the neural network cannot learn how to be efficiently guided by the annotations. This is shown here on the left part of the bottom graphic with the ISPRS case. This was a presentation of our work this year, Deep Image Segmentation with Interactive Refinement. So we thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions or comments, you can contact me here at this email address. And if you want to check out the code, you can do so at this GitHub address. Thank you again.